she had probably defined what a cyborg is, considering that it's the main title of her essay. A cyborg is a human and machine hybrid. She defines humans becoming cyborgs by the end of the late 20th century. She reaches this conclusion by breaking down three main boundaries. The first boundary breakdown that Haraway describes is between human beings and animals. And you can already see this with animal rights activists, who is believing that animals have as much rights as humans, and also just the idea that really what is the difference that separates us humans from animals, other animals. The second breakdown, the second boundary that she breaks down between organisms and machines. Haraway describes cyborgs as caricatures, not copies of humans. She also poses the question, who will cyborgs become?
Kind of
Call Mary Shelley, you think it's a monster in the sense that it's not really a monster. It's just something that's so different from society that people make it out to be this huge thing. But really, it's kind of an innocent thing that just has to learn how to adapt to our world. She also describes fractured identities. Fractured identity is just the fact that you don't ever belong to just one thing. In fact, you are categorized many different ways. So you can be not only male or female, you're also white, black, you're also either like Italian, Japanese, you have many labels to yourself. And then this quote, it's just talking about how what even defines these labels that we make ourselves, like what really defines female as a female. When you start breaking these down, you can start getting into other things, other boundaries break down, like for instance, what you think has to be as your body. Why don't your thoughts expand past your body? What happens when part of your body is gone? Like your robot on your left hand?
Thank you. Then he lay back again. But without taking his hand out of his pocket.
spiritual life of music that I've led.
end gender inequality. Yes, for change. And the more I've spoken about feminism, the more I have realized that fighting for women's rights has too often become synonymous with man-hating. Yes, for change. The belief that men and women should have equal rights and opportunities. I was confused. I started to be sexualized by certain elements of the media. I decided that I was a feminist. Too aggressive. I think it is right that I should be able to make decisions about my own body. To gender equality. Equality ambassadors that made me who I am today. They may not know it, but they are the inadvertent feminists who are changing the world today. We need more of those. And if you still hate the word, it is not the word that is important. It's the idea and the ambition behind it. About freedom. If not now, when? And at current it won't be until 2086 before all rural African girls can have a secondary education. If you believe in equality, you might be one of those that I suppose I and for this, we are struggling for a uniting word. But the good news is that we have a uniting word. It is called he for she. Sisters, I am inviting you to step forward, to be seen, and to ask yourself, if not me, who? If not now, when?